Look out, ChatGPT, with its hundreds of millions of users. Here comes Elon Musk's Grok. This is a new AI chatbot spawned by his startup XAI, which he hopes will rival Google, Microsoft, Meta, Inflection, and Anthropic. Musk says that Grok will have a, quote, massive advantage over other AI models with real-time access of up-to-date information from X. Because the info on X is totally reliable, Elon? I don't know. But the Tesla CEO revealed last night Grok is still in its early testing stages, but will eventually be available to X Premium members. With a new entrant to the chatbot competition, let's bring in one of the AI adults in the room, Tom Siebel, CEO of C3 AI, which, in case you don't know, helps businesses from Raytheon to Baker Hughes to the U.S. Army build enterprise-scale AI applications. Tom, great to have you here. I mean, there's this breaking, too. OpenAI just announced its new, more powerful GPT-4 Turbo AI model during its first in-person event just an hour or two ago. What does the chatbot race look like now that OpenAI is upping its game and Elon Musk is entering?
Well, I think that the bottom line is the amount of innovation that we can expect to see in these large language models in the coming 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years is just mind-numbing. And these people are going to innovate and innovate and innovate, whether it's Anthropic or whether it's Elon or Facebook or whoever it might be. We're just going to see massive, massive innovation and increased functionality that's going to be available to the government, the defense industry, and to consumers, delivering much more powerful technology, unimaginably powerful technology at almost no cost.
At almost no cost. Well, Microsoft slapped a price tag on its earlier iteration, I believe, of $30 a month. People don't seem to be blinking because they are using it in unbelievable numbers. To Grok's sort of DNA, this is what Elon says it does. He says it's able to answer, quote, spicy questions that are rejected by most AI systems. I mean, he says that it understands irony better. I don't know. Most people are looking for facts and ways to write speeches and things, and maybe that is part of it. But it almost seems like it's going to be the class clown of AI chatbots. I mean, is there a market for that?
Well, Elon Musk is clearly, you know, one of the smartest guys in the history of the information technology industry, and so you just cannot count him out. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, he tends to do things a little bit tongue in cheek, but he is an innovator, he is an entrepreneur, and he is as smart as they get. So you cannot count Elon out of this. And you can expect that they will be delivering massive innovation, and the open AIs and the Anthropics and the Googles and the others will be doing everything they can to leapfrog him, and they will be leapfrogging one another in the next decade.
Do you get the sense that leapfrogging means that newer entrants are going to be squished by the side of the road like a bug because some of the bigger guys like Microsoft have invested billions of dollars?
You know, I think it's assumed that one of Microsoft or OpenAI or Google or Facebook are going to win this large language model war. I don't think there's any reason to believe that. You know, when we got to the PC, when we get to the internet, when we get to, you know, all of these new technologies in the past, it's always been some company that nobody ever heard of. By the way, there was a time when nobody ever heard of Google. Remember that? When, you know, Yahoo had 90% market share in search and Google was nobody. So, you know, it's, you know, I think the winner is going to be, you know, to be announced. We'll see who it is.
All right. Well, you guys are already winning. I mean, in your area of the industry, and by the way, for people who don't know, again, I introduced you as the adult in the room when it comes to AI. You started C3 AI back in 2009. You saw the trend, you saw the opportunity, you saw the possibilities there. And what you do is you help businesses create all kinds of AI-driven applications. What is the most exciting thing you feel you have created or accomplished in the past year, just as we're coming up on the year anniversary of the release of ChatGPT?
We did get started before everyone started talking about it. And we spent about 15 years and more than a couple billion dollars building a technology platform that allowed organizations in oil and gas, in utilities, in defense, intelligence, manufacturing, healthcare, telecommunications to build massive scale enterprise AI applications. So now these new developments that we're seeing, you know, supervised learning, unsupervised learning, deep learning, generative AI, large language models, we're able to take advantage of these technologies immediately to the benefit of the United States government, the United States consumer, manufacturing companies. So the businesses, we got started about 15 years before anybody started talking about it. Now the market has kind of come our way.
Yeah, it has. And that's how you got that ticker symbol, AI. Okay, you were so early that you got the ticker symbol. I want to ask you about the stock because you have had an incredible year. It has skyrocketed about 140%. But when you look at the stock internals, one of the things that we notice is that, I mean, 40% of the float is shorted. What does Wall Street have wrong? And does that frustrate you?
Well, I think writ large in, you know, this part of, in say, late 2023, if we're going to, you know, short the AI market, that's a pretty bold bet.
Yeah.
In other words, we don't know how big this AI market is going to be, but it is in trillions. And C3 AI is, you know, if not the leading company in enterprise AI, will be one of the leading companies. Right. So in the long run, I mean, the company has $800 million cash in the bank, rough numbers, and we're a very well-established organization. And what this all sorts out, you know, I think C3 AI will be a great company, and the stock will just take care of itself.
Take care of itself, but not in 2024 when you have telegraphed that you will not be profitable because you'll be taking all of the profits and putting them back into growing the company, correct?
We're investing in growth and we're investing in generative AI in a huge way. And the generative AI opportunity probably doubles the size of our addressable market opportunity almost overnight. So this is just huge.
Tom, come back. It's always good to see you. Thank you.